The new Mac Mini will be coming with an M2 and M2 Pro chipset inside, but today we have great news of that M2 Pro performance revealed and how it will be achieved in this new report. And I want to go over specs, design, so really everything for the new Mac Mini 2022. And of course, I also want to go over the Mac Mini M2 release date and price as well. But first, a quick summary of where we are with the Mac Mini. So Apple updated the baseline Mac Mini in 2020 with the M1 chipset inside. However, Apple still continue to sell the top range Mac Mini, and I'll explain why this is later on in this video. However, for design wise, we haven't actually seen a true redesign to this Mac since 2010, when we went from the kind of plastic design to the full on unibody metal design that we can see here. Shortly after, we had changes like the loss of the CD/DVD drive, then in 2018 we also got a space grey version. However, overall the design has remained the same for about 10 years now. The great news is, Apple are looking to make a whole new design for the Mac Mini based on the renders that you're seeing right here, and also Apple will be putting in a more powerful Apple Silicon chip than the M1 that we currently have right now. What will be the M2 and the M2 Pro? So, moving on with the possibility of an M2 chipset inside. So we've just had the release of the M2 chipset at WWDC, and we already know that Apple is working on the M2, M2 Pro, M2 Max, and even the M2 Ultra. And also, earlier on this year, we also had the Peak Performance event. And a lot of you were hoping for a more powerful Mac Mini, and essentially in a way, we did get this with the Mac Studio. However, it turned out to be more powerful than we imagined and fell more in line as a replacement for the 27-inch iMac that Apple have also confirmed they've stopped making from now on. Apple still hilariously still sell the higher spec Intel Mac Mini, what is slower in every way than the cheaper M1 Mac Mini. Before Apple Silicon, Apple used to sell a lower and higher spec Mac Mini, and they looks like they're going to be doing the same here, just like what we had with the M1 Pro and the M1 Max for the MacBook Pros, and also the same again with the M1 Max and the M1 Ultra in the Mac Studio. It's quite likely that the new Mac Mini will not just get the next generation M2 chipset, but we could also get an option for a higher spec M2 Pro, what will replace the higher tier Intel Mac Mini. So staying on that M2 Pro chipset, a lot of us are wondering how much power it will give us, especially at WWDC we were given the M2 and we now have the benchmarks for that chipset. The original M1 Pro and the M1 Max came at the end of last year in 2021 for the 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros. The M1 Pro and M1 Max has given us a true generation leap in performance over what we had in, say, the likes of the Intel 16 inch MacBook Pro. The CPU performance in both the 10 core M1 Pro and M1 Max is over double of what we got in the highest spec Intel i9 chipset. But we are also wondering now how much faster the M2 Pro and the M2 Max will be compared to the likes of the M1 Pro and the M1 Max. Well, we've had a new report come in telling us that for at least both the M2 Pro and the M2 Max, we'll be getting some additional cores put inside. Looks like that we could be now be getting 12 cores instead of the 10 cores that we currently have right inside the M1 Pro and the M1 Max. This CPU at the moment is made up of 2 efficiency cores and 8 performance cores, and it believed that the M2 Pro and the M2 Max will still have 2 efficiency cores but now have 10 performance cores. This means that we'll get at least 20% increase in performance just to those additional 2 cores. However, like every other chipset manufacturer out there, they also improve their chipsets every year or every couple of years, so combined with these 2 additional cores and just a general boost in performance, we could be expecting between 30 to 45% more power than we have currently in the M1 Pro and the M1 Max. We may also get a few additional GPU cores inside the M2 Pro, so instead of it starting out at 14 GPU cores, it might start at 16 GPU cores as the baseline one. So again, this could give us even more performance gains inside the actual GPU performance. And remember, this does make sense, as because the normal M2 chipset that just came out at WWDC, but a near 18% CPU more power gain, and we also got around about 35% more power in the GPU. So a quick note, with any of these leaks, even up to the new Mac Mini release date, that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof that they will come true, and that with the new Mac Mini, I can only present you what I've been told and shown. However, if you are watching this video, then you are as curious as I am in knowing what is going to be said about the next Mac Mini anyway.
So, just quickly guys, this channel recently got over 350,000 subscribers, what's absolutely amazing. So in celebration of this, I am doing a giveaway right now on this channel for this. It is for a MacBook Air, and this MacBook Air here is the 8-core GPU option with 512 gigabytes of storage, and I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 400,000 subscribers. And all you need to do to enter into this international giveaway is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear or what technology gear you're planning to buy in 2022. And when we get over that 400,000 subscribers marker, I'll be creating a video on this channel announcing who the winner is. So if you are new here, make sure to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell right now. Now, just quickly, I do want to mention there are lots of scammers, there are lots of spammers, a lot of them impersonating myself, and they're telling you to WhatsApp you or to WhatsApp them or to Telegram them. Ignore them completely or report them, because this is not me. Like you've heard from me here, I'll be making a video when we get over 400,000 subscribers announcing any kind of giveaway on this channel, and it will definitely be this time for this MacBook Air here. Well, with that out of the way guys, let's return back to the video.
So, release date next, and we have now started the M2 journey with the M2 MacBook Pro and the brand new design M2 MacBook Air. It is likely after summer Apple continued with putting M2 in the first MacBooks that got the M1 chipset. And if we remember, this was the MacBook Air, the 13-inch MacBook Pro and the Mac Mini. As we know, the Air and Pro are already done, and it's likely the Mac Mini is coming, potentially with the next generation of the M2 iMac as well.
Apple normally do an event in September time, and this is more towards, say, the Apple Watch, iPads, and also the iPhones. However, we normally get another event around mid to end October time, and that showcases the new Macs that come out the end of, say, October or early November time, and it's expected for Apple to release the new M2 Macs at this time.
But moving on, let's do a summary of the 2022 Mac Mini is expected to give us and the prices.
So as already mentioned, we're expecting to get two new Mac Minis this year, the M2 and the M2 Pro. But we're expecting to see this in a brand new design Mac Mini, what will be a first in around about 12 years. It'll be a slimmer Mac Mini, and it will also have a MagSafe power connector on the back, very similar to the likes that we have on the back of, say, an iMac 24-inch. The storage options inside it will go from 256 gigabytes all the way up to 4 terabytes. SSD storage options. You will get the choice of an M2 and an M2 Pro, and this will give you between 2 to 4 efficiency cores and also 4 to 8 performance cores, depending on which version of the M2 and the M2 Pro that you pick. Again, with GPU cores, it will be between 10 to 18 cores of GPU, and again, this depends on the chipset, and also you might get a few less cores if you picked a binned version as well. For actual RAM amount, most likely for the M2, you'll get between 8 to 16 gigabytes, and then for the M2 Pro, it will be 16 gigabytes to 32 gigabytes of RAM. Then the actual body of this brand new Mac Mini will be an aluminium unibody frame body, but then on the back, we're going to be getting some great new ports. We'll be getting 4 Thunderbolt 4 ports, 2 USB 3.2 ports, so this is the normal standard size ports, and then we will probably also get that 10 gigabit Ethernet connection and also HDMI 2.1 as well. The starting price for the lowest configuration with M2 and say 8 gigabytes of RAM, you will pay for a 256 gigabyte storage option. It will be $699, what is the same price for the Mac Mini M1 that we have right now. So as you can see, this time round, there's going to be lots of options for the 2022 Mac Mini. but my wishes for the Mac Mini is to do with the actual price. Right now, the M1 Mac Mini starts in at $699, but the higher spec Intel version starts at $1,099. My fear is that Apple may raise the price of the Mac Mini due to the power that you're getting inside with the potential M2 Pro. However, I'm hoping that Apple will retain the price, especially for the M2 version. However, with a new design and everything, I do not believe this could happen, and especially with the higher spec M2 Pro Mac Mini, I'm quite sure the price will be higher than the version of the Intel one that we have right now. But those are my thoughts and my current wish for this Mac. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with this, and also write in the comments below of what your wishes would be for the new Mac Mini. Well guys, it's time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon.